Let's play piano. Did you notice that the first musical note is same as the eighth note? John Alexander Rayner Newlands, popularly known as Newland, was a famous chemist who was also a musician. He used this concept of repetition while classifying the elements. Was he the first one to make an attempt to classify the elements? The answer is no. Before him, Lavoisier and Dobereiner also made attempts in this field, but that was not a great success. As they were not able to arrange all the known elements of that time in a proper and systematic manner, Newland came up with a new idea to classify the 56 elements which were known at that time. He arranged them in the form of a table. But on what basis? The names in alphabetical order or in the increasing atomic masses? Of course, on the basis of atomic masses. In 1866, Newland arranged the known elements in the order of their increasing atomic masses and found that every eighth element has similar properties as the first element. Newland, being a famous musician, compared his observation with the octaves found in Indian and Western music. Therefore, he called this as Newland's Law of Octaves. Let us first see the first column of Newland's octaves. The properties of hydrogen, fluorine and chlorine were found to be the same. Fluorine is the eighth element after hydrogen and chlorine is the eighth element after fluorine. Similarly, lithium, sodium and potassium resemble to each other in their properties. The other elements which showed similar properties are beryllium and magnesium, boron and aluminium, carbon and silicon, nitrogen and phosphorus, oxygen and sulfur. Hence, Newland's table showed periodicity in the properties of elements when they are arranged in increasing order of their atomic masses. But it had some limitations also. For example, the law was applicable only up to calcium. Newland's assumed that only 56 elements existed in nature and no more elements would be discovered in the future. But later on, several new elements were discovered whose properties did not fit into the law of octaves. Therefore, he adjusted two elements in the same slot to fit elements in his table. He also put some unlike elements on the same note. Notice that cobalt and nickel are placed in the same slot and these are placed in the same column of fluorine, chlorine and bromine, which have very different properties than these elements. On the other hand, iron, which resembles cobalt and nickel in properties, has been placed far away from these elements. For these reasons, Newland's classification was not accepted by other scientists, but its important contribution in the process of classification of elements helped the other chemists. 3 years later, in 1869, Dmitry Ivanovich Mendeleev again worked on classification of elements inspired by the ideas of Newland, taking atomic mass as the basis of classification.